Chiseling the groove. According to the directions, it's a half an inch wide by 3/16 of an inch deep. The problem with these directions is that our chisels are 3/4 of an inch wide. So we're going to make an adjustment to the directions. Instead of a half of an inch wide, it will be 3/4 of an inch wide. Step 16, use the drawings to guide you. Measure 2.5 inches from the square end. Measure not 1/2 inch, but 3/4 of an inch for the width of the groove. That's the same as the width of my chisel. So using my combination square, from the end, I'm going to measure 2.5 inches. Since I'm on the 8, I'll actually have to count the inches out. 1, 2.5. Put a circle around that so I don't get lost in my name. And then we need to add 3/4 of an inch. So from here, I'll just count it out. 1, 2, 3/4. And put a circle. And it's always a good idea to check. So now that I've drawn those, I can lay this on my combination square, and I can see that it's at 3/4 of an inch. Next, I'm going to use my square to draw my straight lines. There's one there, and there's one there. Okay, we're going to chisel this part out. Okay, that was step 17. Step 18, we're going to use our back saw and a miter box to cut exactly 3/16 of an inch deep. You will need to invent a way to measure this. Since you're taking time to watch this video, I'm going to show you a way. We've got this combination square. It does a combination of things. What I'm going to do is I'm going to set this so that it's right at 3/16 of an inch of that ruler protruding out. Then as I'm cutting, I can measure this continually until this fits flat in there. That's at the bottom of the cut, and that's on the top of my block. I also know that this line right here for my radius is at 3/16 of an inch, so I'm going to use that to help me. I'm going to stop just short of that. We can always take more off, but we can't put more back on. Okay, so now we've got our miter box here with our back saw. My miter box is up against the workbench like this. I'll put that in there like that. I use my fingernails to start the cut. I'm not cutting my fingers, I'm just using it to guide the saw and put a little pressure to the side. I'm going to check to see how close I am to my line. And we'll keep cutting until we get down just about to that line. So that's on the line there. We'll stop. We'll go to the next line. Okay, that's as close as I want to go. Okay, firmly clamp your work to the workbench. Use a chisel to remove the material from the notch you created. Do not hit the chisel with a hammer. Use your palm or a wooden mallet. Okay, we have a rubber mallet here today. That will work. I need to get a clamp to clamp that down. I don't want to put this in a vise because my chisel would hit this metal clamp. We're going to put it up flat like that to give us a good workspace. To do that, we'll need a hand screw. Okay, these chisels are pretty sharp. I should just be able to carve that out. If I can't, I'm going to take the beveled edge of my chisel and turn it down so I'm looking at the flat part. and use my mallet. Very gently dig in there. Now this is kind of moving around on me, so I'm going to grab another hand screw to stabilize this because I don't want to chase it around the table. If you're chasing it around, you're doing something wrong. Okay, now I have two hand screws and I can get back to work. Okay, and I can see right now this is starting to chip up right here. So what I might want to do with my chisel, since it's not quite wide enough for the chisel, I'm going to use the edge of my chisel with a bevel towards the middle and just very carefully widen that notch just the tiniest amount. Notice it takes very little effort for this chisel to cut through. If we're using these wisely, they'll be sharp and they'll do what we need them to do. And as you can see, it's making some problem for me. Another trick I can use, if I know I'm using the width of my chisel, is I'll take the chisel itself and make a mark along the side of the chisel, and I can see I need to cut a little bit more off there. Put my chisel right on the mark. Later on, I'll teach you how to use other scribing tools, but sometimes you have to use what's available. There's that 3/16 inch line, so if I go right just a little bit above that, chisel that out. Okay, notice how I'm keeping my chisel flat in there. What I want is, that's bad. I want to keep that as flat as I can in there. Okay, now we're going to use our makeshift depth finder and we're going to come in here and see how deep it is. So I need to go about 1/16 inch deeper. And I'm going to check it all the way across because it's not perfectly level. And at this point I might choose to forgo the mallet. I'm just going to use just my own body. I'm just using my palm right there to get that out. If I'm going to turn around, I'm going to step away from this so I'm not cutting it directly towards me. And this is the part of woodworking that gets very tedious. If you go too fast, you're going to make mistakes, which I already have. Okay, I'm going to go in here and just give this a little bit of an edge treatment. And if I weren't doing this on video for you guys to watch on Monday, I'd probably be going a lot slower right now. But the fact of the matter is, I want you to see the process and not the perfection. Then you can see if you can do yours better than me. Okay, right there, that's kind of stuck. If I lift up, it's going to tear that out. So I'm going to very carefully back that out and break it off right there. Again, I'm not cutting the chisel toward me. I'm stepping to the side as I'm doing this. As I'm doing this, I'm putting downward pressure on the chisel. And I'm just doing small, gradual strokes because I'm trying to feel for the flatness of this as I'm doing it. Let's check our depth one more time. We are so, so close. I think one more pass and I'm going to stop. And I've got some edges right here I can clean up very carefully, holding this perpendicular. And you can see my grain tear out. I'm going to take that off so you can see what I did there. All right, one last check for depth. And we are at 3/16 of an inch deep. My combination square sits flat on there with my gauge set at 3/16. Alright, we're on step 20 now. Refer to the drawing to mark the last groove using any method you have learned so far. For this cut, you're going to go with the grain, so you do not need to pre-cut the edges of the notch. Use the chisel to remove the material from the groove until it is exactly 3/16 of an inch deep. Okay, so there's not as much direction here. We need to return to the drawing. And when I look at the drawing, get my board oriented, I can see that I need to measure 1/4 plus 11/16 from this edge. Okay, I hate math, I hate fractions, so I'm just gonna do it the hard way. Or maybe it's the easy way. Okay, setting my combination square so it's on an edge. Make sure I get this right. My board's oriented the same as my picture. There's my measurements, 1/4 and 11/16. I need to measure up this way. I'll do it right here with the drawing. It's tricky because I have this beveled edge and my ruler wants to creep up here. So if I set it so the shoulder's on there, there is 1/4. I can just count these now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Make a mark. We'll do the same thing on the other end so my line is straight. There's 1/4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And make a mark. And we only need to go from there to there. But I'm gonna go ahead and extend my line out because one of the things on this assignment is that we do want to check for accuracy on the measurement. Now here's another trick we can use. I know my chisel is exactly 3/4 of an inch wide. So if I lay that chisel exactly on the line and make a mark, I'll have what I need. Okay, now this time, it might be tempting to grab your back saw and start making a cut this way, but the blade's gonna contact the wood up there. Don't do it. You may even wanna try to here, but you don't need to do that either. We're gonna take this back saw, get that out of here. We're gonna clamp this thing back down to the workbench. I think I'm gonna use a corner for this one. Okay. It's very important to use a wood clamp. Use a wood screw here, so if we miss with a chisel, we've got something soft for a nice sharp chisels to hit. Make sure that's good and tight. Okay. Before we start cutting down, we want to start marking the edge of the board. So we're just going to take our chisel, set it right on the line, cut down into there very gently, make sure that we're not tearing the wood out too much. And the bevel is toward the inside of the cut. The flat edge is facing away. Okay, same thing there. We set the chisel on the line. Okay. And this, with the bevel edge down going with the grain, I can usually just push it in with just some force. I can also use my palm of my hand to get that started. Looks like I've got a little bit of an angle there. So when you first start it, you want the bevel side down because we want to hog out. That's what it's called, is hogging out material. Once I get this started, I've got some nice clean edges now. I want to check my depth, and to do that, I want to reset my combination square to 3/16 of an inch right there. And I can check my depth and see that it's not quite right. Okay, now I can use the bevel side up. This time it's going to make my cut nice and flat across the bottom. And you can turn your chisel over if you need to get a piece off of there. Okay, and it's going to be chunky at first, but then as we go through, if the bevel side is up and the flat side is down, it should be pretty good. Look how smooth that is now. Okay, and if I need, I can very carefully shave that off. Okay, and I'm looking to see that these are the same thickness. So this cut here, the cross cut, is deeper than my rip cut. So we're going to go a little bit more. And it's better to take many light cuts rather than one thick cut. Pay attention to the direction of your chisel. You don't want to rotate it too far to the left or to the right. Take special care to make sure that it's nice and flat. Checking depth. Almost there. And there we have it. So I've reached the dimension. I have a few stray things here. I'm going to very carefully use the sharp edge to cut those off. And voila. Finishing up. Step 22. Now wasn't that fun? Make sure your name and period are on your board. See step 3. Seems like a silly thing to say, but look what happened to my board. My name is now gone, so I need to rewrite that somewhere on here. Step 23. Finally, you need to write an entry for our class catalog of interesting things. On an index card, write a description of this object that you might find in a catalog. Include the material that you used, who would be interested in it, and its possible uses. Pretend you're putting this on eBay or Etsy or Amazon. What would it say? So, to do that, we need to go find an index card. Write your catalog entry, and include it with your hand tool project. I'm curious to see what you can come up with for a use for this. Good luck!